She's undoubtedly one of the best known family faces in television. Let's say hello to one of the presenter, Nuala, Carey.
Hello. It's lovely to have you here. Well, it's nice to be here because the last time you invited me over, we had to cancel because of the snow.
That's not going on.
And like, it has been one of the busiest years when it comes to weather. Do you enjoy the kind of frantic nature of it, especially this year, or would you like to spend any?
Well, I suppose in terms of working, you know, on live television, it is something different. But I suppose like most people, I like good weather, so I'm happy enough with the heat wave. And I have great sympathy for the farmers who have had, you know, very tough few months. But I know overall most people like good weather, and I do too. And I'd rather open the curtain and see a bit of sunshine than a hurricane as we did back in October.
Yeah, absolutely. So here we go now. I've got Nuala on one side. I've got Martin on the other. Go on. How much more of the sunshine are we going to be seeing, Nuala?
How many more?
Yeah. Oh, you do that too.
Well, like, actually, the temperatures are probably what we would be expecting for now. Like, that is so unusual.
I know.
But sure, everybody had the best time. And ice cream makers made a fortune. Soft drink producers made a fortune. So for some people, it worked out really well. But again, my poor farmers who I have great sympathy for, and I have farmers in my family, and I know it has been very awkward for them. And the drought and the hose pipe ban. Sure, listen, we could go on for an hour and a half.
I know.
So, pros and cons.
Yes, yeah, the yin and yang. Of course, but listen, of course, you started at a low point.
That's right, yeah.
Now, you did tell the blogs, well, at least one little white lie, and your mother had to come in and sort it out.
Yeah.
What was it?
You see, I had to be in for 6:15, right? So obviously I wanted the job, but I couldn't drive. The irony of it, on a road watching, I couldn't drive. And so I said to them, sure, don't worry, because there's a bus every morning at 5:30, so I'd be fine. And then technically, what was it? I looked into it, it didn't go the whole way to town, so it's not good to me. So my mum knew I really wanted the job, and I really wanted the job, so she said, leave it with me, and she got up every morning and drove me to town to the job.
What? For how long?
For about a year and a half.
Oh my God, who looked up for Nuala's man? Come on. Wow.
She has been rewarded every birthday and
Listen, anything I get invited to, and I always say to people, my mum is the first person I invite. She can have first refusal.
Oh, yeah.
Because I feel like my mum helped me so much, she has to enjoy some of the perks. So I bring her everywhere with me, and we're kind of like a double act now. And I went to the Rose of Tralee a few years ago, and we were sitting now, I think in the second row, with brilliant seats, and the panel of pantalon, it showed my mum, never showed me. And people said to me after, so your mum went to the Rose of Tralee, did you not go? I was like, I was there.
Where?
Just acknowledge to me anymore.
It's
just like, where's your mum?
Well, I've heard that she won't miss a single broadcast that you do. Is that true?
Well, she'd be a very encouraging mum that way. My dad now is great as well, but my mum has been at weddings, and like dinner would be at most weddings, the start to serve it maybe coming up to 8:00, and she would excuse herself and she'd run upstairs to the bedroom and just check the lot and watch it, see it went okay, and then went out to the room. Isn't that cute?
Oh, look at the
room. I love that photograph. I was at my older sister's communion.
That's a beautiful picture.
Mom looks like she works for Angus there, doesn't she? She never did. The uniform is so perfect, doesn't it?
Skip it out in weddings. Now everyone will know. They'll be like, I'm with anything to the leader. Like, she's not.
She just wants to check that everything is okay.
Yeah. It's not just your mom who's a fan, though. A certain Oscar winner, Jared Leto, wasn't he very impressed with you?
Well, now that story grew legs. I did meet him, like, a long, long time ago. When I told the story years later, it kind of, which was very embellished, and it sounded like, you know,
withering heights.
Yeah,
you had a whole thing going on.
And it wasn't like that at all. I met him. In fact, I didn't even know who he was. And I actually would watch a lot of TV, but I never watched that program.
My so-called life.
I never watched it.
What?
I know, and I didn't have any
history. Oh my God.
Because it was my friend.
But then at this stage, it was like, by the time I got to papers, it was like, Nuala shifted Jared Leto, and
it wasn't true, but I just say, I know